Hi, this is Ali Arango of LittleGuyCGI.com, and today I would like to show you how to set up a character rig inside of Blender 2.77a. So let's get started. Okay, if this is your first time in Blender, I recommend you go to File, User Preferences, go to Input, and then choose Select with left click. Blender's default select is with right click, and this may confuse you if you're coming from Adobe or other 3D programs. Also, while you're in here, click on Add-ons, scroll down, and make sure you have a check mark next to Rigging : Rigify. Okay, actually, there's one more thing that we need to do in User Preferences. So we'll go to File, User Preferences, Add-ons. Make sure you have a check mark right here next to 3D View : 3D Navigation. Okay, when you put that check mark next to 3D Navigation, now if you look all the way to your left and you click right here, you should see these buttons here. And these buttons just allow you to easily manipulate your view in Blender. You can also hold your middle mouse button while in Blender to rotate your view. In Blender, there's a bunch of different modes, but there's two, for this tutorial, there's three main modes that we'll be dealing with. That's object mode, which when you come into Blender, you're in object mode. If you click here, you can go to edit mode. And what we're about to do is we're about to bring in armature into here. Now, once we bring the armature in, we'll then also have the option to go into pose mode as well. Okay, what this tutorial is going to be dealing with is we're not going to be taking the armature that we're about to bring in here and connecting it to an actual character. I'm just going to basically show you how to set up the rig so that it's ready for movement, such as things like inverse kinematics on the legs. We're going to set up IKFK switching for the arms. Things kind of like that. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is select this cube. We're then going to press the X key, which brings up our delete menu. We're then going to choose X to delete the cube. I'm then going to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, press A. This brings up our add to menu. So what we're going to do is scroll down to where we see armature. Then we're going to click right here where it says Human Meta Rig. Okay, to zoom in closer on this, we're going to hold down Shift. While holding Shift, we're going to press B. We're going to then draw a box, zoom box, I like to call it, to zoom in, you know, closer to this Meta Rig. I'm now going to hold down Control and then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back just a little bit. Okay, with this armature currently, we're looking at it and we're in object mode. We want to go into edit mode so we can add some things and take some things away from this armature. So with the armature selected, you can tell it's selected by this orange outline on it. We're going to click here and then select edit mode. Okay, what I'm going to do now is hold down shift, and then while holding shift, press B. I'm going to draw a zoom box right here. I'm going to click here. I'm then going to press X to bring up our delete menu, and we're going to delete that bone because we don't need it. We're also going to click here. We're then going to press X to bring up our delete menu and then click delete bones to get rid of that bone as well. Okay, what we're going to do now is hold down Control, then hold the middle mouse button, and I'm just pulling back while holding Control and holding the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm holding Shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view now. And now what I'm going to do is press C for paint select. I'm going to select all of these bones right here. Then I'm going to right click to get out of paint select. I'm then going to press X to bring up the delete menu and then choose delete bones to delete those bones right there. Okay, the reason why we deleted the bones right here is because we're going to set up constraints and, you know, just a bunch of different things to this leg. It's going to take a little bit of time. So once that's done, the work that we're going to do on this leg, we'll just copy this leg over to that side, and that just saves us some time as far as, you know, There's no reason to duplicate the work when we can do the work on this leg and duplicate it over. Okay, so I'm gonna press and hold shift, then press B to draw a zoom box again. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm then gonna hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view. I'm gonna click right here. I'm gonna take the manipulator and move this up some. Then I'm gonna take the manipulator and just pull this back some like that. I'm gonna click right here and push this forward some like that. I'm also gonna click here and push this down a little bit more like that. Okay, now I'm gonna hold down control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm gonna hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm gonna then hold control and the middle mouse button to zoom back again. And the first thing we wanna do is set up inverse kinematics for this leg. Okay, and what inverse kinematics are is typically if you're posing an armature like this, the armature as it is, if we bring this into pose mode, this armature will move with forward kinematics. And what that means is if I want to grab this arm and move this arm, I'll grab it from here, you know, turn, rotate this bone, and this entire arm will rotate, right? Same thing with the leg. If I grab the leg here, I'll rotate this bone and all the other bones will follow. And that's useful particularly for the arms having, you know, FKs, which are on the armature by default. However, when you have to deal with posing the armature where it has to work against a force like the ground, like this armature standing on the ground, it's then useful to be able to pose the armature instead of from this end, kind of like where the joint starts off at. It's easier to pose it from where the joint ends off at. So with inverse kinematics, basically what we'll be able to do is to grab one of the bones around here and then push up, and then this entire leg will push up. And hopefully you'll be able to understand as we go along just by seeing how it works. Okay, the first thing we have to do as far as setting up inverse kinematics for this is we have to deal with this bone right here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button. This is going to be our first handle bone. So we're going to use this bone to basically pose his leg with the inverse kinematics. The first thing we need to do is select this bone, and then we need to clear the parent of this bone. And basically this bone is parented to this piece of the leg right here. For inverse kinematics to work right, we need to take the parent off of that, off of this bone. So what we're going to do is with that bone selected, we're going to hold Alt, and then while holding Alt, press P. Our clear parent menu pops up, and then we're going to select clear parent. Okay, while it doesn't look like anything really happened, now this bone should be unparented, cleared. This bone has cleared the parent, cleared itself of this bone right here, and that allows us to be able to set up inverse kinematics. So typically when you're dealing with armatures, you add bones and do your parenting in edit mode. To set up constraints, you do that in pose mode. So with this bone selected here, we're going to click here and then click here to go to pose mode. Okay, for now, this bone is going to be our handle. So this bone is going to be what we use to control the movement of this leg with the inverse kinematic set up on, which, once they're set up, which we're about to do now. So the way it works as far as setting up inverse kinematics, you take your what I call the handle bone, which is this. You make sure you have that selected first, then you hold shift, and then you select the next part up in the chain of the bones that you're going to be working with. So I'm going to left click here. The order is very important. So we selected this first, we selected that second. So now what we're going to do is we're going to press and hold shift, and then while holding shift, we're going to press I. Okay, when we did that, our Add IK menu popped up. We're then going to choose two active bone. And what that did was that put on our inverse kinematics constraint on this bone right here. And it's set up for this bone to control not just this bone, actually, but this entire leg. However, what we need to do is, like, if I click right here and then I press G, you see how the whole entire armature is moving? We don't want that. So what we do to deal with that, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. This manipulator is kind of getting in my way temporarily, so I can click here to temporarily take the manipulator away, just so this is easier to select. Anyway, with that done, I'm going to click here, and now I'm going to hover my mouse here, pull this out some. This right here, this bone next to what looks like this chain, this is our bone constraint menu, so I'm going to click here. And to make this work right, what we need to do is to work with this chain length right here. Currently, it says chain length 0. We need to change this and take this up to 2. So now with that chain length being 2, now when we grab this handle bone and we press G, you can see that the leg is moving how we want the leg to move. So I'm going to right-click to get that bone to jump right back into place. Okay, now with that inverse kinematic set up, the cool thing is now we can easily pose his leg by grabbing this handle. However, something else cool is if we click here, and I'm going to click this button right here to bring back our manipulator tool. If we press G, you see that? So now when we pull down here, the leg responds to the rest of the body. So typically, if you want to have a character, you know, bend down, you would, you know, grab the main bone right there and, you know, pull down. However, see how the foot is moving? So, like, basically the only thing that looks stable is our handle bone right there. So we want to deal with that. So I'm going to right-click to get this to jump, you know, back to its original resting place. Okay, and as far as dealing with this is pretty simple. I'm going to press and hold Shift, and then while holding Shift, press B. I'm then going to draw a zoom box right here. And what we need to do is we're currently in pose mode. We need to parent this bone to this bone right here. So to do that, we're going to click here and then select edit mode. So now we're back in edit mode. You can see right here. So now we're going to select this bone first. So we want this bone to be parented to this bone. So we select this first, hold shift, and then while holding shift, select this bone. So then with both of those bones selected in the order that we just set them up, and well, we just hold control, and then while holding control, we press P. Our make parent menu pops up. We have two options, connected and keep offset. You want to choose keep offset. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click here and then go back to pose mode. I'm going to hold down control, and then while holding control, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and pull back. I just let go of the middle mouse button. I'm still holding control. Now I'm going to hold the middle mouse button again and pull back to zoom back some more. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. And then now you'll see that when we grab right here, I'm going to right click to get that 3D cursor to move to the side. When I press G, you see how the foot now is stable. So basically you can have the character, you know, bend down and have the foot look right like it's standing on solid ground. And we accomplish that simply by taking this bone and then parenting this bone to this bone right here. Okay, what we want to do now is to set up an ankle rig. And basically what that means is, or what I mean by that anyway, is we want to make it so that when this character walks forward, we can easily make the foot bend. So that's what we're going to set up now. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, press B. We're then going to draw a zoom box right here. We're going to click here to go into right view. We're then going to go right here where it says view perspective slash ortho. We're going to click here. If you're ever confused about what view you're in, you can always look right here and see the view. I think it's always you can look right here anyway. Okay, in this view, and the reason why we came to this view is because orthographic view is kind of like a blueprint view. It allows you to look at things as though they're 2D. It's very good for setting up things or aligning things. So what we're going to do now is hold down control, hold the middle mouse button, and pull back some. I'm then going to right-click right here. The reason why I did that was when I right-clicked, I brought the 3D cursor here. In Blender, where the 3D cursor is at is where objects tend to come into Blender at. Okay, currently we're in pose mode to bring the bone in that we want to bring in. We need to be in edit mode, so we'll click here and then go to edit mode. So here in edit mode, we'll press and hold shift, then press A. That brought this armature bone in. I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back some. You can see that this bone is selected at the head at the top. Here's a 3D cursor at the bottom. Why is that important? because we want to make this top of this bone go right to that 3D cursor, we can do that easily by holding shift, and then while holding shift, press S. This brings up our snap to menu. We're going to choose selection to cursor offset, so the selection is the top of the bone, and we want to snap that to the 3D cursor at the bottom, so we'll click that. That makes it look like the bone disappeared. It didn't disappear, we just basically scaled it down to nothingness. That's good though, because now we can take our manipulator and push out like this. Okay, and if this 3D manipulator is getting in your way, you can click here to temporarily take that away. And basically with this bone, what you want is this bone to be pretty much matched up with this, you know, front of that bone there, as well as the back of this bone, you want to be matched up with that bone right there. Okay, this bone is matched up as far as from the side. Let's see how it looks from the front. However, before we do that, we're going to click right here so we have this whole bone selected. So we're in the right orthographic view. We're now going to click front view. So we're in the front orthographic view. I'm going to hold down control, hold the middle mouse button to zoom back, then hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. And you can see that from the front view, this bone is nowhere close to, you know, the leg where we want it to be. So we'll click here to bring back our manipulator, and then we'll just push this over to where we want it to be. Okay, I'm going to press and hold shift then press B to draw a zoom box. Just to zoom in a little bit, we'll push this over a little bit more like that. Okay, what we're going to do now is we are going to click the right view here. We're going to click this bone here. We're going to hold shift and then click here. We're then going to hold down control, and then while holding control press P. This brings up our make parent menu. We're then going to choose keep offset. We're then going to click here and then hold shift and then click here. And then press and hold control, then press P. This brings up our make parent menu. We're then going to choose keep offset. Okay, now with that done, what we're going to do is we're going to click here and then go to pose mode. We're then going to press A to deselect all of our bones. We're then going to click this bone first, and then with this bone click first, we're going to hold down shift and then click this bone second. And then with those bones clicked in that order, we're going to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, we're going to hold down control, and then while holding control as well as shift, we're going to press C. And now this brings up our add constraint menu. We're then going to choose copy location. When we did this, this bone jumped up. That's fine. To deal with that, what we're going to do is just click right here. And then see where this says head slash tail. We're just going to take this slider up to 1. Okay, what we need to do now is to add some new bones. So we're going to press A to deselect here. We're currently in pose mode. We're going to click here to go back to edit mode. And what we're going to do is select this bone and then hold shift and then select this bone. So with both of those bones selected, I'm going to press and hold shift and then press D. And what we did is we just duplicated those bones. I'm just going to move my mouse button just a little bit just so you can see that here are the duplicated bones. Then I'm going to right click to get those bones to jump right back into their original position. Okay, so what we have going on here is it looks like from this view there's two bones here. However, we know that we have the additional two bones that we duplicated. I'm going to press the N key to bring up our properties panel. I'm going to scroll down. The reason why we came in here is so we could see the name of the bone. So when we click on a bone that is right on top of another bone in Blender, Blender will switch between the two. So this was the original bone here. So when I click on this bone, again, you see that switches to the second bone that's in the same position. So what we want to do with this bone is we want to click here and rename this foot underscore roll dot L and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, now we need to rename the other bone that we duplicated. We'll click right here, and when we click there, see how it says toe dot L dot 001. Typically, if you have a bone in Blender that's a duplicate of another bone, Blender will put this dot 001. So this is the new bone, which is what we want. So we're going to click here. Then we're going to name this toe underscore control dot L, and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, so what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here, and we want not this bone, the other bones. We're going to click again. So we want this foot underscore roll dot L bone. And with that selected, we're going to click here and then go to pose mode. Now, the reason why we came into pose mode was because these bones are right on top of each other, and it's important that we know which bone we're selected. We are selecting. What we can do is press R to rotate to pop this bone up some. So now what happened is with this bone selected here, we can clearly, you know, see what this is and this bone. However, when we click and go back to edit mode, the bones are on top of each other. Okay, so I'm going to click here and go back to pose mode. You can see when we're back in pose mode, the bones are still separated, which is good. So what we want to do now is we want to take off this constraint right here, which is our copy location constraint. So we want the copy location constraint on this bone, but not on our foot underscore roll dot L bone. So what we're going to do is just click this X to take that constraint off of this bone. Okay, so what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click this toe underscore control dot L bone. And it's nice because here in pose mode, we can clearly see that we're selected on this bone and only this bone. So with that done, we're going to click here and then go back to edit mode. Now in edit mode, that bone is right on top of the other bone. However, we know that we have this selected because, and when I say this, I mean the toe underscore control dot L bone, because we selected that in pose mode. So with that bone selected and only that bone selected, we want to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, click right here. Okay, so now with that done, we're going to press and hold control, then press P while holding control. This brings up our make parent menu. Then we're going to choose keep offset. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect those bones right there. We're then going to click here, then go back to pose mode. We're going to click this foot underscore roll dot L bone. That's why we came back in here, so we could clearly select that bone. So now we're going to click here and then go back to edit mode. So with that bone selected and with us being in right orthographic mode, we're going to press R to rotate 180 and then enter to lock that in. So that let us, pressing R to rotate 180 let us rotate this bone 180 degrees. Okay, now when you look at this bone, you see this bone, how it almost looks like a 2D object. This bone, you can just see, you know, like it looks 2D, this bone. See this bone right here? You can see that it's slightly turned. We don't want that. However, that's easy to deal with. We're going to just press and hold control, then press N. We're then just going to choose global X-axis. We're then going to press and hold control, then N again. We're then going to choose global Y-axis. We're then going to press and hold control, then press N again. We're then going to choose global Z-axis. And now this bone is set up the way we want it to be set up as far as how it's turning, or how it's turned, I should say. Okay, what we want to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here. We're then going to click here to go into pose mode. We came into pose mode so we can clearly see this bone. So with this bone selected first, we're now going to hold shift and then select this bone. So then we're going to click here and then go back to edit mode. So with this bone selected first and then this bone selected second, we're going to hold down control and then while holding control, press P. Our make parent menu pops up, and this time we're going to choose connected. The previous times that we've parented bones, we've chosen keep offset. However, for this time, we're going to choose connected. Okay, so what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here to go to pose mode. We're then going to click here. This is actually getting in my way, so I'm going to click here to temporarily turn that off. We don't want the toe dot L first, so I'm going to click here. So we can see we have that toe underscore control dot L. So what we're going to do is press R to rotate to get that to pop up some, because we need this to be selected first. Now we're going to hold down shift and then select this bone second. So with this bone selected first, and then this bone selected second. We're going to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, press I. We're then going to choose our add IK menu pops up. We're going to choose to active bone. You know, this jumps kind of strangely. That's fine. We're now going to click here. We're going to change this chain length to 1. And then we're going to take this check mark away from use tail. Okay, now for this next step, with those bones still selected and selected in that order, we're going to hold down shift, and then while holding shift, we're going to hold down control. So we're holding shift as well as control, and now we're going to press C, and then we're going to select copy rotation. Okay, now with all of that set up, that being, you know, the bones, we're going to press A to deselect and A to select all of the bones. We're then going to hold down Alt, then press R. While holding Alt, we're going to press G. And what that did was that reset the rotation as well as the any movements for any of the bones. Okay, so with all of that done, I'm going to press A to deselect. Now when we click here, then press G, we can see that our foot moves. Our foot as well as our leg moves. I'm going to hold Control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. And when we click here and then press R to rotate on the x-axis, we can see that our foot flexes. I'm going to right-click to get that to reset to its original position. We can also see when we click here and then press R to rotate on the x-axis, we can make the foot, you know, come back or go forward like that. So then I'm going to right-click to get that to jump back to its original position. Okay, so what we're going to do now is, with this bone selected, we're going to name it foot underscore handle dot L. It's very important that your bones, the new bones particularly that you bring in, that you name them and have like dot L on the side, if it's on the left side like this bone is, because when you go to animate this rig, if you want to do things like copy a pose and then reverse the pose, if you do not have all of the bones named with a dot L on the one particular side, then when you want to copy a pose and then reverse that pose, you're going to have issues. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to add a pole target to this leg. So currently we're in pose mode. We want to go to edit mode to add a bone in. So we're going to click here. Then we're going to select edit mode. And what we're going to do is we are going to click this knee joint right here. I'm then going to hold shift, and while holding shift, press S. That brings up our snap to menu. I'm then going to choose cursor to selected. I'm going to click here to go to front view. And now what I'm going to do is hold down shift, and then while holding shift, press A. That bone just came in. I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. We have the top of the bone selected here. I'm going to click here to bring back our manipulator tool. I'm going to hold control and then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back some more. And I'm just going to push this down to, shrink the size of that bone. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to hold shift and press B, then draw a zoom box to zoom in. I'm going to select that new bone right there. I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. And then I'm just going to push this bone out to about here. I'm actually going to click here to temporarily take away the manipulator, click the tip of the bone, click here to bring the manipulator back, and just make this a little bit smaller like that. Okay, as far as why I brought this bone out to this distance, you want this leg to be able to bend up without it running into this bone. So you want to have enough space so you can imagine this leg like bending up, because this is a pole target. What we're going to do is use this to control the angle of the knee. Okay, so the reason why we have it about this far out is just that his leg should be able to come up without, you know, touching this this pole target. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to click here to select the bone. We're then going to click here to change the name. So I'm going to name this PT.L, and then press Enter. And that's just short for pole target. And then the .L is basically letting us know, or letting Blender, more importantly, know that this is a bone that's on the left side of the armature. Okay, what we're going to do now is set up this pole target. So to do that, we need to go back to pose mode. So currently we're in edit mode. We're going to click here and then select pose mode. And then here in pose mode, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button just to rotate the view. What I'm going to do is I'm going to left click on this bone that has our IK constraint on it. And then if you look right here, you can see this says pull target right here. So we're going to click here. This, the entire armature is called the meta rig. So we're going to click meta rig, right? Now we have this other place that says bone. So we can click here. And then what we can do is hover our mouse here and then press P. And then Blender knows that as we put in, you know, words that sound like it, it should, PT, there we go, pop that bone up. So there's PT.L, so we select that. Typically what happens is the bone, when you put a pull target in, it turns to the side. And then if you click here and then put a negative 90, enter, then normally, you know, the IK bone is set up to be correct as far as working with the pull target again. Okay, now with that set up, what it should be is when we click this bone now, if I press G to move on the X axis, you see that? How we can actually control the tilt of the angle of the leg there. So I'm going to right click to get this to jump back to its original position. If I click here and then push down, right? And then if I click here, you can see how this pull target allows us to control the angle of the knee. So what I'm going to do now is press A to deselect that bone, then A to select all the bones. Then I'm going to hold Alt, press R, and then hold Alt, then press G just to reset the positions of all of the bones back to their original starting position. Okay, what we want to do now is press A to deselect. Now when I click here and then press G, I can move the leg, right? However, what we want is we want this pull target to move with this leg as we move it. So that's pretty easy to set up. What we're going to do is let's press A to deselect that bone that was just selected, which was that bone. We're going to click here and then go back to edit mode. Now we're going to select this bone first and then hold shift and then select this bone right here. Then we're going to hold control and then while holding control, press P. This brings up our make parent menu. And then we're going to choose keep offset. Okay, now with that done, what we're going to do is click here to go back to pose mode. So now when I click here and then press G, you can see that that pull target moves along with the leg. It basically stays in a general area of the leg. I'm going to right click to get that to jump back to its original position. And that's what we want. Okay, so what we're going to do now is turn our attention to the arms. So what we're going to do is click here to go to edit mode. I'm then going to click here to go to front mode, or front view, I should say. Sorry, not front mode, front view. I'm going to press A to deselect right there. I'm going to hold shift as well as hold the middle mouse button to pan down. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. What we want is this bone, and this bone. All right. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to hold control, then hold the middle mouse button. I'm actually going to click here. I'm then going to press E to extrude, and then right click. So we created a new bone here. We just didn't pull it out. Now I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view. And I'm going to take this manipulator and just pull back so we can actually see that bone that we just made. Okay, so originally I said we want this bone, and this bone. What we really want is this bone, and this bone. What am I talking about? Let me press A. What I mean is we want to select those bones. And what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate those bones right there, those three bones. And basically what we're going to set up here is we're going to set up an FK-IK switch so that this arm can work in FK mode as well as IK mode, you know, whenever we need it to be in whatever mode we need it to be in. So I'm going to click here, hold shift, click here while holding shift, and then click here while holding shift. So I'm going to then press and hold shift, then press D. I just duplicated the bone. I'm going to move my mouse. I didn't click anything. I just moved the mouse, and I do that just to know that I have this bone actually, these bones actually duplicated. I'm going to right click to get those bones to jump back into place. I'm then going to click here to go to front view. I'm then going to hold control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back, right? We're in front orthographic view, which is important. Okay, the reason why we want to make sure we're in front orthographic mode is because we're going to use this grid to help us with moving these bones around. So I'm going to hold down control, and then while holding control, I'm going to left click and just pull up. Now this bone jumped up. The reason why it jumped up was it jumped up one measure of movement on this grid. And the reason why we did that is because that will allow us to easily place this bone back into position right over this bone right here. We move this bone up because it will allow us to work easier, you know, not having this bone on top of this bone right here. We're also about to duplicate this bone again, and just having the bone separate, I find it easier to work with. However, we need to put them all back eventually right into place right over here. At least that's what I want. Okay, with those bones still selected, we're going to press and hold shift. While holding shift, we're going to press D. I move just to the side without, you know, clicking or, you know, whatever. I just move to the side just so I know these bones are duplicated. I'm going to right click to get them to jump right back into place. I'm now going to hold control and then left click my manipulator and pull up. And we can see, you know, this jumped again a unit up because we were holding control, which is what we want. Okay, what's going on here is we're going to use these bones right here to deform the mesh or whatever this armature ends up in, whatever mesh that it ends up in. These bones here are going to be the FK bones. These bones here are going to be the IK bones. And having these different bones here is what's going to allow us to be able to switch fairly easily between FK and IK. Okay, and just so, like when I say FK, what I mean that it's short for forward kinematics. IK is short for inverse kinematics. You might say, okay, well, what's the big deal? Why do you want to switch between them? Things that have come up with me, like there's been times where I've wanted a character to either do a push-up or like I was doing an animation where I was having a character jump over something, or I was planning to eventually have them work towards jumping in a vehicle, right? When you have a character push on something with their arms, that's where you want it to be. That's where you want the armature's arms to be set up for IK, when it's the character is pushing against something. And it works well as long as you're like, imagine a guy, you know, he's running up, he's got a car or vehicle or whatever, and he puts one hand to brace his weight, and then he jumps while using the hand to brace his weight into the car, right? That's where you want IK, something like that. Or somebody is doing push-ups. You know, their arms are locked to the ground, they're doing push-ups. And that looks IK, using the IKs for that kind of animation looks right in that instance. However, if you have somebody throwing a ball, you want the FK or forward kinematics because the motion just looks smoother. There's nothing pushing against the arm, so to say, for FK. So just to put it shortly, IK is used for things like having a character do push-ups, having a character push somebody else, hold something that has some kind of weight to it, where FK is used for doing something like throwing a ball or just basic motions like having a character walk, like swing its arms as the character walks. Okay, so let's set up our inverse kinematics for this arm bone chain right here. So the first thing we need to do is click here. I'm going to click here to temporarily take away our manipulator. I'm going to click here. And what we need is to have this be have the parent cleared to set up our inverse kinematics, very similar to what we did with the leg. So to do that, we're going to hold Alt, and then while holding Alt, we're going to press P. Our clear parent menu pops up. We're going to choose clear parent. Now with that done, what we're going to do is click here and then go back to pose mode. Okay, now here in pose mode with this already selected, we're going to hold down shift and then select here. And then with this bone selected first and this bone selected second, we're going to press and hold shift and press I. Our add IK menu pops up. We're then going to choose two active bone. Okay, now what we need to do is set the chain length for that bone. So we go to what looks like this bone and this chain here. We click there. We look for our chain length here and we take this up to 2. Okay, now with that done, I'm going to press A to deselect and I'm going to click here. Then when I press G, you can see that this arm, we're able to pose it simply by grabbing that handle right there. So I'm going to right click to get that to jump back into place. Okay, now let's add a pull target for this arm. So what we're going to do is I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm then going to click here to go from pose mode back to edit mode. Okay, now what I'm going to do is hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to click right here. I'm then going to hold shift, and while holding shift, I'm going to press S. I'm then going to choose a cursor to selected right there. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. Okay, I'm going to now press and hold shift, and then while holding shift, I'm going to press A, which adds a bone, which you can see right there. I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm going to click here to bring back the manipulator. I'm going to take the manipulator and push down to shrink that bone down some, like that. Okay, I'm going to hold down control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom in some. I'm going to click here, pull this back some, like that. Then push this down some, like that. I'm actually going to hold control and the middle mouse button to zoom in, hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan, hold control and the middle mouse button to zoom in some more. I'm going to click right here and make this a little bit smaller, like that. I'm then going to press A to deselect the tip there. I'm going to click here to select the entire bone right here. Okay, I'm going to click here to change the name of this bone. I'm going to name this PT.A, so we know it's, you know, an arm pull target, and then put in .L and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, so now what we're going to do is click here to go to pose mode, and then here in pose mode we're going to click here on our IK constraint. We're then going to click right here, which is our bone constraint panel. We're then going to click here, select meta rig. When I first was learning how to rig, I used to click on pull target and expect it to say PT, you know, whatever bone. First you have to select the meta rig, and then we're going to click here. Now we click the bone, so we're going to put PT, just start typing, and then Blender, you know, automatically goes and pretty much finds the bone for us. So now we just select this bone right here. Typically when you set up your pull target, it jumps, and then if you click here and put in -90, enter, the angle of the bone is set up correctly after inputting this value right here. Okay, I'm going to hold control, hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. And now when we click here, you can see that we can adjust the angle of that arm. So I'm going to right click to get that bone to jump back to its original position. I'm then going to press A to deselect that bone right there. Okay, now with that done, let's go back to edit mode. We're going to click here and then select edit mode. Okay, and here in edit mode, what we're going to do is click this first. The order is important. Select this bone first, then hold shift, and then select this bone. And then with the bone selected in that order, you're going to hold down control, then press P. You're then going to choose keep offset. So now as we move this arm around, our pull target that we're going to use to control the elbow of the arm, you know, should follow along. So I'm going to press A to deselect now. Okay, something else that needs to be done. I'm going to hold shift, then while holding shift, press B to draw a zoom box right here. If we click here and then go back to pose mode, if I click here and press R to rotate, this hand doesn't move. I want this hand to move when we rotate this bone right here. So I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm then going to click here and then select edit mode to go back to edit mode. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to first select this bone right here, and then I'm going to hold shift, and then while holding shift, I'm going to click and select this bone here. Now I'm going to hold down control, then while holding control, press P, and then our make parent menu pops up. I'm then going to choose keep offset. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. Now when we click here and then go back to pose mode and we click here, now when I press R to rotate, you can see the hand moves, which is what we want. So I'm going to right click to get that bone to reset to its original position. I'm then going to press A to deselect. Okay, I'm going to hold down Control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back some. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. Okay, what we're going to do now is set up some copy rotation constraints. I used to get confused slightly when I did this before. Basically, in edit mode, typically what happened is when you want to set up a child-parent relationship, first you'll select the child and then you'll select the parent. So you'll select child to parent something, which isn't what we're doing here. You would select a child, you know, hold shift and then select the parent, while holding shift and then hit control P, which, you know, parents the child to the parent. Here, we're about to use shortcuts to set up constraints. However, it's kind of like the opposite, or is the opposite. So basically, I want to have this bone copy the rotation of this bone. So if we were parenting, I would select this bone first, which would be the child, and then this bone second, which would be the adult. However, when setting up constraints using shortcuts to have this bone follow that bone, it's the opposite. So first we select this bone here, then I hold shift, then while holding shift, I select this bone. And then with this bone, which is the bone that I want to control the rotation, selected first, and then the bone that I want to be controlled by the rotation selected second, I now hold down shift, control, and then while holding shift and control, press C. And then I select copy rotation. Okay, I'm gonna hold shift and then press B, then draw a zoom box to zoom in a little bit closer so you can see. Now when I click this bone here and I press R to rotate, you see that? And that's what we want. And what's going on is this bone here is copying the rotation of this bone because of what we just did with the constraint that we just put on, which was a copy rotation constraint. As a matter of fact, if I click here and then click here, here you can see here's our copy rotation constraint. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do that the same thing with these bones and these bones. You know, so we're going to copy the rotation, set up to copy the rotation from this bone to this bone. So we're going to select this first, then hold shift. While holding shift, select this. We're then going to press shift, control, C. Select copy rotation. We're now going to select this bone first, hold shift, then select this bone while holding shift, and then press shift, control, C, and select copy rotation. And you can see which bones have constraints on them by the color changing, like these are changing. Okay, so with that done, what we're going to do is we're going to click here. Then we're going to click here. We're going to change this to FK. So we know that this is set up to control an FK constraint. We're going to click here, press FK, and then click here, and then click here to again name the constraint that's on this bone FK. Okay, I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan down. And we're basically going to do pretty much the same thing that we did before with copying the rotation of these bones to our main bone here, which again, this bone is going to be these are going to be the bones that deform the mesh that this armature eventually would end up in. So what we're going to do is we're going to first click here, then we're going to hold down shift and then click here. And then we're going to hold down shift while holding shift, press control while holding shift and control, then press C. And then we're going to select copy rotation. Okay, now what we're going to do is click here, hold shift, and then click here. And then now we're going to press and hold shift while holding shift, press and hold control, and while holding shift and control, then press C. And then we're going to add our copy rotation, and then we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to click here, hold shift, and then click here, and then while holding shift Control and C, we're going to select copy rotation. Okay, and with all of that done, now when we click here and then press G, you can see that our arm is following that IK setup. I'm going to right click to get this to jump back into place. I'm going to click here now, and I want to name this IK for all the constraints that have that we're going to use for controlling the IK setup. So I'm going to hover here, pull this out to the side some. I'm going to click here and name this IK. And press enter to lock that in. Click here. Then click here to name this IK. Then press enter. And then click here and then name this IK. And then press enter. Okay, so what we have here is this arm has two sets of copies of copy rotation constraints. It has FK copy constraints as well as IK copy constraints. Because the IK copy constraints are at the bottom of this stack that shows, you know, how the bone constraints are lined up, the IK has dominance. So when we move the IK, as long as the influence is all the way up for the IK, even though the influence is all the way up for the FK, and this influence just basically, like, when it says influence 1.000 just means like 100% influence. Same thing with the FK here. It's 100% influence. So even though they both have 100% influence, because the IK is at the bottom of the stack, it has dominance over dominance or priority, however you want to put it, over the FK, whose influence is also currently, you know, on 100%. Okay, I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom back some. So basically, if we want to have an IK set up now, we press G for the IK, and, you know, our arm moves, you know, just like it moves with this IK setup. However, if we click here and then we scroll down a little bit and I turn off the influence for this bottom IK stack, now when I click here and then press R to rotate on the Y axis, now with our FK setup, our main arms that we're going to use to deform a mesh, you know, move like they're supposed to move. So I'm going to right click to get this to jump right back into place. I'm then going to press A to deselect. Okay, we need to name these bones right here. So we're going to click here, then go to edit mode. I'm going to press and hold shift, and while holding shift, press B, then draw a zoom box right here. I'm going to click this bone right here. I'm going to click here to name it, and I'm going to name this IK.A.Handle.L. Just press enter to lock that in. I'm going to click here, then I'm going to click here and name this FK.A.Handle.L. Then press enter to lock that in. I'm then going to name this, clicking on there and then clicking here, df.a.handle.l, and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, with that done, what we're going to do is hold down control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. What we're going to do now is organize our scene a little bit by putting these bones on different bone layers. So I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to click here to go to front view. I'm then going to press Z and then select wireframe view. I'm then going to, by the way, for wireframe view, you can also click here and go to wireframe view as well. I'm going to hover my mouse right here. I'm going to hold down control. Then I'm going to hold down the right mouse button. I'm going to then draw a lasso select right here. So with that selected, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to pose mode. And then with those bones selected, I'm going to press the M key. And what you see here with the M key is you see bone layer groups, or I should say bone layers, period. The bone layers that are here are different from the bone layers. The bone layers that you see here are different from the regular layers that you see in normal Blender, all right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that whole IK chain for now, and then I'm going to click here, and when I click here, those particular bones are going to move to this layer right here. Okay, so as far as where those bones actually went, if we click here, see these layers right here? So this layer right here is where I just sent that bone chain to. And as far as the rest of our armature, where you can see these highlighted layers, the rest of the bones on this armature are basically spread out over here. And when I said like these layers are different from the blender layers, what I meant was like for the regular 3D viewport, you see these boxes right here. Each of these are layers. However, this is separate from this. And when I first heard about it, it was confusing to me. This is, you know, you organize different objects in Blender by selecting here, and this right here, found under, you know, this armature panel, these layers are just for organizing bones. Okay, so what I want to do now is take this bone chain, and then I want to put that right here, all right? So, how I'm going to do that is I'm going to hold down Control, and then hold down the right mouse button while holding Control, and then I'm going to draw a lasso select, like this, around this bone chain. I'm then going to press M to bring up our Change Bones layer panel, and I want those bones to go right here. So when I click here, they move there, right? And then right now you can see there's a dot that popped up right there. So that's where those bones went. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I want to click this bone because I want to take this bone and move it to this layer. So I'm going to press M, and then I'm going to select this layer right here. And now when we look here, we see a dot just popped up showing us that that bone moved to where we want it to move to. Okay, what I want to do now is make sure that I have the control bones easy to get to. So for that, I'm going to hold down Shift, and then I'm going to select this layer right here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click right here. I'm then going to press M, and then I want to put this bone right here. And it should pop up right there, and there it goes. Okay, and I want to put the elbow control with the other bone, so what I'm going to do is hold down Shift and select here. So now I'm going to click on this bone right here. I'm then going to press M, and then I'm going to click right here. And what I did was I just moved the IK control bone as well as the pull target bone to this layer so I can easily get to both of those bones. Okay, for now, I want to see all of the bones, so I'll just hold down Shift and then click here, as well as here. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here to go to front view. I'm then going to click here to go back to edit mode. Okay, you want to make sure you're in front orthographic view. I'm then going to hold down Control, then hold the right mouse button down so I can draw a lasso select around this bone chain here. And then with that done, what I want to do is I'm going to hold down Control, and then I'm going to take the manipulator and then just push that back down into place. And that jumped back right down into place because we were holding down Control. We're in front orthographic view, so Blender is using this grid to affect how things move. And it did that again because I was holding down the Control key as I moved that bone chain. Okay, now we want to do the same thing again. So we're going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover my mouse right here. I'm going to hold down Control, then hold the right mouse button, then draw a lasso select around this bone chain right here. And then I'm going to hold down Control, and I push down, and then push down again, and then let go of both the left mouse button as well as the Control key. Okay, now I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to press Z and select solid. You could also have gone to here and selected solid. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to take a look, and it's how we want it to be. All of the bones are right on top of each other. You know, it looks like the other bones disappear, but they're just placed exactly on top of each other. Okay, what we're going to do now is click here, then go to pose mode. We're then going to hold down Shift, we're going to deselect these layers right here. And what we want to do is, I'm going to click here. We want to make sure that the influence for our IK is on. Is when I say on, I mean all the way up for our influence. So this is one now. We'll click here, take this influence up to one, or really think of it as being 100. We'll click here and then take this all the way up as well. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to set up to rig these hands. I'm going to hold shift, and then while holding shift, press B. I'm then going to draw a zoom box right here. Okay, we're going to need to add a bone in. So we're going to click here to go to edit mode. I'm going to hold control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom in a little bit more. And what we're going to do is select this bone right here. I'm going to press and hold shift, and then while holding shift, press D. Then left click to lock that in. I'm then going to lift this bone up some and press S to scale it down some. I'll just pull it out a little bit here. We're going to use this to control the other bones in the hand. Okay, so let's name this bone. So we're going to click here. We're going to name this finger dot control dot L, then press enter to lock that in. Okay, now that we have that bone made and named, we're going to click here and then go back to pose mode with this bone selected first and then this bone selected second. We're going to hold down shift, control, and then while holding shift and control, press C. This brings up our add constraint menu. We're then going to choose copy rotation. And here is our options. Here are the options, I should say, for our copy rotation. We're in our, you know, copy constraints menu here. We want to click here and change this to local space for both of these options. Okay, and now with that done, I'm going to press A to deselect. Then I'm going to click here. If I press R to rotate on the y-axis, you can see that one finger moving. So I'm going to right-click to get that bone to jump right back into place. I'm then going to press A to deselect. And this is pretty cool. So what we're going to do now is we're going to press C. We're going to select all of these bones all right here, including these bones here as well. I'm then going to right-click. And then with this bone selected last, I'm going to hold down shift and then select that bone. What we're going to do is we're going to go to pose, constraints, and then copy constraints to selected bones. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. Now I'm going to press A to deselect. Now I'm going to click our control bone here, and now I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. And you can see that how our hand bends or flexes, whatever you want to call it. Very cool. I'm going to right click to get that bone to jump right back to its original position. Then I'm going to press A to deselect. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to click here, then go back to edit mode. I'm going to hold down control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view. I'm going to hold control and the middle mouse button to zoom back some more. I'm then going to click here to go to front view. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to press Z to go to wireframe mode. You could also click here and go to wireframe mode as well. I'm going to hover my mouse here. I'm going to hold down control and hold down the right mouse button. And what I'm going to do is I am going to select all of these bones right here. I missed that one. I'm still holding control. I'm going to draw another lasso select. There we go. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and zoom back. I'm then going to press X to bring up our delete menu, then choose delete bones. Okay, what we need to do now is to make sure that these bones are named correctly. So to do that, we're going to click here, then go to pose mode. And we're going to click here. Now here we have our IK bone set up here and our FK bone set up here. I just remember how that was. This was the main control bone. So if your setup is the same as mine here, and it should be as long as you followed along with me, I'm going to hold down shift. This should be the form arm. So I'm holding shift. I'm going to click that. Okay, that's the hand, not the deform arm. This should be the arm. I click that, and I'm going to click this, which is our IK. So I'm going to click here, and the reason why I clicked there was so we could see the name here. And see, this says forearm.l.004. The 004 is probably going to cause us issues. So what we're going to do is just come in and we're going to take that away, as well as name this IK underscore, and then press enter. I'll click here. Same thing, we'll just take away these numbers here. Just backspacing. And then I'm going to put an IK in the front of here. I'm going to press enter. Okay, our IK arm chain should be good now. So I'm going to hold shift. I'm going to unclick this. Now I'm going to click right here, and this should be our FK chain right here. Okay, so we're just going to click here. Same thing, we're just going to click here, take away these numbers, as well as the period that's before the numbers. We're then going to click in front of here, and then put a FK underscore, then press enter. We're then going to do the same thing for this bone. So we're going to click here, just backspacing to get rid of the numbers as well as the period. And now I'm just clicking in front of the name here. Then I'm going to put FK underscore and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, so what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to hold shift, click here, as well as here, as well as here, as well as here. Okay, and the reason why we made sure we have these layers selected is so that when we go to edit mode and we copy these bones, duplicate them, so we can, you know, put the bones on the opposite side of this armature, we need all of the bones to be currently showing as they are now. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to click here and then go to edit mode. We are now going to need to take this 3D cursor and put it here. We're going to do that by holding shift, and then while holding shift, we're going to press C. 3D cursor jumps right to the center, which is what we want. We're then going to hold shift, then B, then draw a zoom box just to, you know, get our view back in a decent place where we can work with it again. We also need to change the pivot point of Blender from Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point, to the 3D cursor. Okay, so with the 3D cursor being right here, as well as the pivot point being changed to the 3D cursor, now we can select these bones right here. So I'm going to hover my mouse about here. I'm going to hold down control. Then while holding control, I'm going to hold the right mouse button. Then I'm going to draw a lasso select around here. Missed that one. Just want to do it again for right here. Got it. However, see this? You don't want that. I'm going to hold shift and B, draw a zoom box right here. You don't want anything in the center selected, so I'm going to press C for paint select. I'm then going to hold the middle mouse button to depaint that. I'm then going to right click to get out of paint select. I'm then going to hold down control, then hold the middle mouse button and pull back to zoom back. Then I'm then going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to zoom back. Okay, with all of these bones selected, we're going to press and hold shift, then press D. Our bones should be duplicated. I'm going to pull to the side just a little bit. I'm not left-clicking, right-clicking, or doing anything. I just pull to the side just so I know that those bones are duplicated. I'm then going to right-click to get those bones to jump right back into place. Okay, and with those duplicate bones selected, what I'm going to do now is press S to scale and the X-axis -1, and then left-click to lock in. Now with those bones still selected, I'm going to press W, which brings up our specials menu. I'm then going to select flip names to flip the names. And basically what that means is before these bones were named, you know, dot L, long story short, when we selected flip names, now these bones should be all named dot R. So they have the same names as these bones. They just have dot R instead of dot L. And that's actually very important, particularly when you want to do things like copy poses and then reverse poses as you go to animate this armature. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here to change Blender's pivot point from the 3D cursor back to Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point. Okay, and with that done, we're going to click here and then go back to pose mode. Okay, and for the most part, everything looks okay. I see a little change right here. I'm pretty sure that this is good. I'm not sure why it's showing like that, but we're going to test out our rig right now. So we're going to press Z and then select solid view. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to hold shift and then hide these layers right here. Zoom in. So we'll grab our hand bone right here. I'll press G. Looks good for that side. Grab here, G. Pull target's working correctly. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm then going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to click right here, and then I'm going to press G. That looks good. I'm going to right-click to get that to jump back to its original position. I'm then going to click here, and I'm going to press G. The pull target looks like it's working correctly. I'm going to right-click to get that to jump back to its original position. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button. I'm going to hold shift the middle mouse button to pan. Hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to click here, then press G. Leg looks like it's moving correctly. I'm going to right-click to get that to jump back into its original position. I'm going to click here, press G. Pull target looks like it's working correctly. I'm going to right-click to reset the position for that. I'm going to click here. I'm going to press R to rotate on the X-axis. That looks good. Hold the middle mouse button. I'm going to hold shift the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to click here to temporarily take away the manipulator. I'm going to click here. Then I'm going to press R to rotate on the X-axis. Looks good. I'm going to right click to get that to jump back to its original position. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to click here, press G, looks good. I'm going to right click to reset that position. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to click here, then press G. The pull target looks good. I'm going to right click to reset that position. I'm then going to press A to deselect. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to click right here. I'm then going to press R to rotate on the X-axis. Looks good. Then I'm going to right click to reset the position for that bone. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm then going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view. I'm going to hold the control button as well as the middle mouse button to zoom back. Then I'm going to click right here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view some more. I'm then going to press G. Okay, it looks good. And you can see the pull targets and arms are keeping the arms stable there. I'm going to right click to reset the position for that bone. Okay, now we'll take a look at our hand rigging. So I'm going to hold down shift and press B and draw a zoom box right here. We'll click right here and then press R to rotate on the Y axis. And that looks good. I'm going to right click to get this bone to go back to its original position. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold down control and hold the middle mouse button and then pull back. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. Then I'm going to rotate the view. I'm going to hold shift and press B, then draw a zoom box right here. Okay, so we're going to select this bone. And it already, the angle of it doesn't look right. So I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. See, that's moving to the side. That's not right. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. Yeah, we don't want that. So I'm going to right click I'm then going to hold Alt to reset the rotation of that. I'm going to hold G. I mean, hold Alt, then press Alt and G to reset the rotation. And most likely, the axes aren't correct. So what we're going to do is we're going to click here. And when I click there, basically you can see, you know, Z, X, and a Y axis right here. And what this should be is the Z axis should be pointing down this direction. Okay, there's a couple ways you can go about dealing with that. Both ways need to be done in edit mode. So currently we're in pose mode. So we're going to click here and then go to edit mode. And if we scroll up here in edit mode, we can see where it says roll. And this roll, by controlling this roll, we can basically roll these axes to where we want them to be. So what we're going to do is we're going to press A to deselect, and then I'm gonna hover my mouse here. I'm going to hold Control and hold the right mouse button, then draw a lasso select all around here. And then what I'm going to do is press and hold Control and then press N. And then when I did that, that brought up our recalculate roll menu. I'm then going to choose global negative Z axis. And you can see that all of these flipped basically. So now the Z is facing downward like it should. Okay, I purposely dodged the thumb because that looks like it's correct. I'm going to press A. Then I'm going to click here, then go to pose mode. Well, then click here, and then I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. And things look like they're working correctly now. I'm going to right click. I'm going to hold Control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom out some. Hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. Then I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis again. And the hand looks like it's working correctly now. So I'm going to right click to get this to go back to its original position. Okay, now I'm going to click front view. I'm then going to hold Control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm holding Shift and middle mouse button to pan. Holding Control and the middle mouse button to zoom back some more. Holding Shift and middle mouse button to pan again. Okay, when we click right here, then I press R to rotate on the Y axis. See how the body's moving, particularly the legs. We want to have our rig have the ability to have more maneuverability than that. So I'm going to right click to get that to jump right back into its original position. And this is pretty easy to deal with. What we're going to do is we're going to click here, go to edit mode, hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to turn off these axes. With this bone selected, we're going to press and hold shift. Then while holding shift, press D to duplicate that bone. I'm then going to right click to get that bone to jump right back into position. I'm going to scroll down and we can rename this bone. I'm going to name it root underscore handle. We don't need a dot L or dot R because it's right in the center. So I'm going to press enter to lock that in. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're just going to press R to rotate on the X axis 180, and then left click to lock that in. Okay, now I'm going to press and hold shift, then press B. While holding shift to draw a zoom box to zoom in. And the duplicate that we just made, we just rotated that 180 degrees. Now what we need to do is to click this bone right here, hold shift, and then while holding shift, click our new bone, which we named root underscore handle. Then we're going to hold down control, and then while holding control, press P. That brings up our make parent menu, and then we're going to choose keep offset. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're then going to click here to go into pose mode. We're then going to hold down control, hold the middle mouse button, and zoom back. We're going to click this bone right here. We're going to then click this button right here. With this bone selected, see where it says inherit rotation right here? We're going to take away this check mark by clicking it. Okay, now with that done, we're going to click here to go to front view. We're going to click this bone right here. Then we're going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. And now you can see that our hips can actually swivel back and forth. So they have a lot more maneuverability now, which is what we definitely want. Since we, you know, have the rest of our armature rigged up, like our hands, our ankles, and all that. Okay, and to make things easier as far as posing this armature, I'm going to click here so we can see our layers. I'm going to click this bone right here, then I'm going to press M, and I'm going to move that bone to this fourth layer right here. And the reason why I did that is so now we can just grab here, press R to rotate on the Y axis, and we don't have to be concerned about grabbing the other bone by accident. Okay, what we want to do now is deal with an easy way to switch between our FK chain and our IK chain. So if I hold the control button and then hold the middle mouse button and pull back, that allows me to zoom back. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm now going to press G, and you can see, you know, our pull targets are working, right? If I want to have this arm particularly go in FK, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to hold shift and deselect right here, and then still holding shift, click here, and that just gives me access to our, you know, main bone that we are going to use to, that we would use to deform a mesh in the future with this armature. So I'm going to click here and then go here, scroll down, take this influence down to zero, then click here, do the same thing, take this down to zero, then click here, and then do the same thing and take this influence down to zero. Okay, now, and this bone came back temporarily, that's fine for now. But now when I press G, you see how this arm now, it's this arm here is acting like an FK bone instead of an IK bone. Ugh. And the first time doing a tutorial in a while, my mouth is like struggling here for the pressure of the camera. Anyway, this FK chain right here is working like how it should, and this arm, you know, still has the IK. Now, we could have this arm where we just select here, you know, and deal with that influence. However, there's an easier way to deal with this than selecting this, this, and this, and then, you know, changing that influence. For now, what we're going to do is select here. We're going to turn this influence all the way back up. We're then going to click the influence here, turn this all the way back up, and then click here, and then turn this all the way back up. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to click here. We're then going to scroll down. We're looking for custom properties, which is right here. We're going to click here. We're then going to click add. Scroll this down a little bit more. Then we're going to click edit here. We're going to click here. We're going to name this arm underscore IK underscore strength dot L, and then press enter to lock that in. And all of these settings should be okay, so we'll click okay. Okay, so basically what we just did is we made a slider that we'll be able to use to control all three of the influences for this arm chain here. However, we have to go through the process of setting this up to work with this so that when we move this, the influences for the IK are changed. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to use drivers. Currently, when you see all of this stuff here, this is Blender's default workspace. If we click here and then select animation, this is Blender's animation workspace. I'm going to hold shift and press B, then draw a zoom box right here to zoom in to our armature here. Okay, here in our animation workspace, we can see the F-curve editor here. I'm going to hover my mouse right here and then drag this up. What we want to do is click here and then turn this to drivers. And then what we're going to do is pull this out to the side some. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to hold down Control and hold the middle mouse button to zoom in some. I'm going to hold Shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to hold Control and middle mouse button to zoom in some. We're going to click here. We're then going to click here. When we zoom down, we have two sets of influence. We have the FK, which is all the way at the top, right? And then when you scroll down more, you have the IK. Do not make the mistake of adding the driver to your FK. Scroll all the way down to the bottom. Make sure you're on the IK driver. And then with the influence for the IK driver here, you're going to right click and then select add driver. And we're going to do this for all of these bones right here. So we can see we're in IK right here. We're all the way at the bottom, which is good. So we're going to right click and then select add driver. Same thing right here. It says IK, we're at the bottom. We're going to right click here and select add driver. Okay, with that done, we're going to click here, hold shift, and then while holding shift, select here as well as here. Okay, what we're going to do now is I'm going to hover my mouse here, pull this out a little bit. I'm going to hover my mouse over this area. It's important where you hover your mouse at. In Blender, depending on where your mouse is at, tends to affect your shortcut keys. So I'm hovered over this area right here. I'm going to press N to bring up our properties panel. I'm going to select right here the top driver. And what we want to do is we want to scroll down to where we see drivers. See where it says scripted expression? We want to click here, change this to average value. We want to scroll down some more. We want to change this transform channel to single property. Then we want to click here and then select armature and then click here and then select armature as well. Okay, what you want to do now is click here. We want to look for our custom property. So I want to click this arrow to open it up. Scroll down a little bit more. I'm going to right click here and then select copy data path. I'm then going to click here and then hold down control and then while holding control press V. And then I'm going to press enter to lock that in. Okay, now we're pretty much just going to repeat that process. So we're going to click here, change this from scripted expression to average value, change this from transform channel to single property, click here, change this to armature, click here, then change this to armature, click here, and then hold down control while holding control, press V, and then press enter. We're then going to click here, change this from scripted expression to average value. We're going to change this transform channel to single property. We're then going to click here, change this to armature, and then click here, and then change this to armature, and then click here, and then hold down control, and then while holding control, press V, and then press enter to lock that in. Okay, now what we're going to do is see where it says error right here, so we'll click here. We don't see that there. We'll click that. We'll click here. We still see that error, so we'll scroll up. We'll select Update Dependencies. We'll then click here. There's the error, so we'll click Update Dependencies. And now that's taken care of. By the way, if you see an error message up there, if you go to File, User Preferences, and then select File, see right here where it says Auto Run Python Scripts? Sometimes when you put a check mark right here, it'll take care of that error message that you see up there. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to hover my mouse here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to hold Control and the middle mouse button to zoom the view. So when we select right here and then press G, you can see our IKs are still affecting both of our arms, right? However, now with this slider, we can just grab here and slide this down. And now when I press G, you can see that instead of the IK chain affecting the arm, the FK chain is affecting it. So I'm going to right click to get that bone to jump back to its original position. Okay, so now we need to go through the process with the other arm. So we have our custom properties right here. We're going to click here. We have this new custom property. We're going to click edit. We're going to click here and change the name to arm_IK_strength.R. Then press enter. to lock that name in, and then we're going to select OK right here. Okay, so now I'm going to rotate the view. By holding the middle mouse button, I'm going to select right here. I'm then going to click here. Remember, we have our FK on top. You'll see the FK influence. You don't want that one. You want to scroll all the way to the bottom with your IK. You want this influence, not the one above this, okay? So I'm going to right-click, select Add Driver. I'm then going to left-click here. We can see this is our IK. We're all the way down at the bottom. Good. So we're going to right-click, select Add Driver. We're then going to click here. We can see this is our IK. And we're all the way at the bottom. So this is the influence we want. So we're going to right-click and select Add Driver. Okay, and with that done, we're going to click here, hold Shift. While holding Shift, select here as well as here. Okay, I just select all three of these bones here just so we can see all of our drivers right here. I'm going to click here, hover here, pull this to the side. We're going to go to Scripted Expression, change this to Average Value. We're then going to go down to Transform Channel and change this to Single Property. We're then going to go right here, click here, then select Armature, then click here, and then select Armature as well. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to click here. Then we're going to scroll down to our custom property. We're going to hover here, right click, then select Copy Data Path. We're then going to scroll down here a little bit, click here, hold Control, then while holding Control, press V, and then press Enter to lock that in. We're then going to click here, change this from Scripted Expression to Average Value. We're then going to change this from Transform Channel to Single Property. We're going to click here, select Armature, then click here, then select Armature. We're then going to click here, hold down Control while holding Control, press V, and then press Enter to lock that in. We're then going to click here, change this from Scripted Expression to Average Value. We're then going to click here and change this from Transform Channel to Single Property. We're then going to click here, select Armature, then click here, and then select Armature again. And then we're going to click here and then hold down Control, and then while holding Control, press V, and then press Enter to lock that in. Okay, we're just going to click here. And I'm looking to see if there was any error messages, which there doesn't seem to be. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button, or there actually isn't because we don't see them. But anyway, I'm going to click here. So now when I press G, you can see the IKs are on there. So now I'm going to right click. So now we have our slider here. So now when I turn this down and then I press G, now we can see that our arms are working just like FK chains instead of IK chains. Okay, we're almost done. We need to click here and then go to edit mode. We need to add a bone in that will allow us to have this character jump. So I'm going to press A to deselect. And the way we're going to do that is I'm going to hold down the control button, hold the middle mouse button to zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan up. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan up a little bit more. And then I'm going to click here, hold shift, and then click here. And now with both of those two bones selected, I'm going to hold down Shift. And then while holding Shift, I'm going to press S. This brings up our Snap To menu. I'm going to choose a cursor to selected. So what that did was our 3D cursor was put directly in between our two bones right there, which is what we want. And then with our 3D cursor in that position, what we're going to do is press and hold Shift. And then while holding Shift, press A. And this bone right here popped in. So now what we're going to do is hold down Shift. And then while holding Shift, press S. And now we're going to choose Selection to Cursor Offset. The reason why we did that was by doing that, we pretty much scaled the bone down to nothingness. And now we can take our manipulator and push the bone out this way and get the bone to face directly straightforward. Okay, now what we're going to do is I'm going to roll my mouse wheel here. I'm going to click here to temporarily turn off that manipulator. I'm going to click right here, then click this button to turn the manipulator back on. Push this back a little bit more. I'm going to hold Control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom in. I'm actually going to click here. We're currently in the animation workspace for Blender. I'm going to go back to the default workspace for Blender just by selecting default. And here we were able to come back to the default view for Blender. I'm going to hold control, hold the minimize button, zoom back some. And then if we click here, if you want to get back to the animation, you know, you can just click right back here. That'll take you right back to animation. Oops, let's stay in default. Okay, now that we have this here, what we want to do is we want to parent our root bones to here, as well as our IK bones. So I'm going to hold control and then hold shift. Now I'm holding shift and middle mouse button. Now I'm going to hold control again. So I'm going to select here, hold shift, and then select here. And then with selecting those two first, I'm now going to select this last. And then I'm going to hold down control, and then while holding control, press P. And then I'm going to select keep offset. I'm going to then press A to deselect. I'm also going to click here and name this bone the main underscore root. Yeah, that's good. Then I'll press enter to lock that in. Okay, now I'm going to hold down control, then hold the middle mouse button to zoom back some. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan the view. I'm then going to click this bone right here. I'm then going to hold shift and then select our main root bone. I'm then going to hold control, and then while holding control, I'm going to press P and then select keep offset. Okay, what we're going to do right now is I'm going to click here, go back to pose mode. I'm going to scroll up so we can see our bone layers. And then I'm going to unclick this and then click this. And the reason why I did that was I wanted to make sure that the bones that we parent to our main root bone are the bones that we need to control our IKs. Okay, when I say IKs, what I mean is our IK chains. Okay, so what we're going to do now is click here to go back to edit view. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm then going to hold shift, then press B, then draw a zoom box here to zoom in some. I'm then going to click here. I'm then going to hold control and then hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm then going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. Okay, I'm going to hold down shift and then select right here. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan up, hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. And then with both of those bones selected, I'm going to hold shift and then select here. And then I'm going to hold down control, and then while holding control, press P. This brings up our make parent option, or make parent menu. I'm then going to choose keep offset. Okay, I'm now going to hold down control and the middle mouse button to zoom back. I'm then going to press A to deselect. I'm then going to click here and then select pose mode to go into pose mode. Okay, now with all of that done, when we click here and then press G, we can move the entire armature around. So I'm going to right click to get that bone to jump back to its original position. Okay, as far as working with this armature, I'm going to hold shift and hold the middle mouse button to pan. I'm then going to hold A to deselect right there. We have our control bones right here. I'm going to hold control and then zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and then hide that. And then I'm going to click here, which is our IK bones. Sorry, not our IK, our FK bones. I'm going to click here. I'm then going to press M. And then I'm going to move this bone to the fourth layer. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to rotate, or shift and the middle mouse button to pan, middle mouse button to rotate. I'm then going to click here. I'm then going to press M. And then I am going to move this as well to that fourth bottom bone layer right there. And when you are working with this mesh, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Then I'm going to hold control and the middle mouse button to pan back. When you're working with this armature, you're going to want to have these layers selected, this layer selected, as well as this. So basically, let me scroll down here. Right now, with this strength being zero, we have things set up so we can work moving by our FK chain. So if I click here and then press R to rotate on the Y axis, you know, we can move our arm like this. I'm gonna left click to lock that in. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I can, you know, click here, then press R to rotate on the X axis, and our arm will, you know, bend just like that. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I'm then gonna press A to deselect and A to select everything. I'm then gonna hold Alt and then press R and then press G to make sure that everything is reset. When we go to use our I keys, then we would, you know, turn the strength for this all the way back up. Then we would just grab here and then press G. And when we move our I keys, you can see the bone here, like invisible view. However, bones don't render when you're working on an animation. But if this does annoy you when you're working with your I keys, what you can do is scroll up and then you can just hold shift and then just, you know, unclick this layer. So now you're just working with your I keys there. So I'm going to hold shift and bring that layer back. I'm going to scroll down here. I'm then going to press A to deselect, and I'm going to press A again to select everything. I'm then going to hold Alt, then press R, and then G to get everything to jump right back into place. I'm then going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm then going to hold Control and the middle mouse button to zoom back. Okay, everything looks good. I'm then going to right click to get this to jump right back into place. Okay, and the last thing that I would recommend you do as far as working with this armature is just to select the head bone and then select this bone button right here and then uncheck inherit rotations. You want to just click here to take this check mark away. And I typically do that to the armatures that I work with just because I find that when you go to animate, that tends to help out a lot not having the head rotate along with the rest of the body. So I'm going to press A to deselect that bone right there. Okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. Hopefully this tutorial will help you out as far as when you want to take a meta rig like this and set it up for when you want to put that meta rig inside of a mesh that you're going to use for an animation. For all of those of you out there who like the videos on this channel and reshare them, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. And to those of you who are new to this channel, if you like the videos on this channel and you would like to see more, please subscribe and thank you for viewing.